Welcome back once again. Today I am going to talk about File Transfer Protocol FTP. The topics discussed are connections, communication, file transfer, user interface, and anonymous FTP. FTP or file transfer protocol is used for copying a file from one computer to another, to a remote computer. Actually, it is a standard mechanism provided by TCP/IP for file transfer. While transferring file from one system to another, there may be some problems. That is, the two systems may use different naming conventions. Their naming conventions may be different. And there may be differences how they represent the text and data. And also they may differ in directory structure. And all these problems can be handled by FTP. And the important things to note are FTP uses the services of TCP, and for FTP to perform file transfer, it needs two connections, one control connection and one data connection. The well-known port 21 is used for control connection, and well-known port 20 is used for data connection. The figure shows the basic model of FTP. So the left side you can see the client, and this is the server, and we have the control connection and data connection. And at the user side or the client side, we have user interface, control process and data transfer process. And at the server side, we have two components, the control process and data transfer process. And over the control connection, or the control connection is between control processes on the client and server. The data connection is between data transfer processes on the client and that of server. The control connection remains connected during the entire interactive session. That is, when we want to transfer files from client to server using FTP, first of all the connection is established, and the control connection remains as long as we are planning to transfer files using FTP. But the data connection will be opened and closed for each file transfer. So from the client to the server, we are making FTP transfer, and the control connection is active throughout the session, whereas the data connection is active for each file transfer. So this I have already explained. Now this figure shows how we are using the control connection for FTP session. So between the control processes we have the control connection, and actually FTP uses 7-bit ASCII, and this is somewhat similar to the approach in SMTP. And here the connection is achieved, or the communication is achieved, through commands and responses. And this is enough as we are sending only a single command or response at a time. Now, this figure shows how we are using the data connection in FTP, or how is the communication over a data connection take place. So the data connection is between data transfer processes, and this data, while transferring this data, the file type, the data structure and transmission mode, all these are defined by the client. So this is only up to the client, and the server has nothing to do with it. And to start the data transfer, we need the control. We need the commands or responses that made through the control connection. And the file transfer involves retrieving the file, storing the file. Retrieving means we are copying a file from the server side to the client. That is, we are accessing a file at the remote site. And storing a file means we are trying to store or copy a file from the client side to the server. In addition to these two, another thing is that a list of directory or file names, which is to be sent from the server to the client, and this is also treated as a file. Hence, we are considering it as file transfer. So, in the figure, we have seen that the client is defining type of the file, structure of data, and transmission mode. And the type of file means FTP can handle ASCII, EBCDIC, or image file. Of these, the ASCII file format is the default format for FTP. So the sender will send a file or transfer a file in ASCII format. And at the receiver, this ASCII format is converted to the receiver's own representation. Now, if any of the side, that is the client side or the server side or both, is using the EBCDIC format, then the file can be transferred in EBCDIC form. And about the image file, it is actually the default format for binary file. In this, the file is sent as a stream of continuous bits. These are usually used to transfer binary files such as a compiled program. Now, coming to data structure, FTP uses any one of the interpretations, file structure, record structure, or page structure. I repeat, file structure, record structure, or page structure. If you are using a file structure, a file is actually a continuous stream of bytes. And if you are using a record structure, a file is divided into records. And actually, this can be used only with text files. And if you are dealing with page structure, the file is divided into pages. And each page will be having a page number as well as a page header. And these pages can be stored as well as accessed randomly or sequentially as required. And coming to the third point, transmission mode. It can be stream mode, block mode, or compressed mode. So, take the case of stream mode. This is actually the default mode in file transfer using FTP. Here, the data are delivered from FTP to TCP as a stream of bytes. As it is stream, we are transferring as stream of bits. And now TCP is responsible for dividing this stream of data into segments of suitable size. So, from FTP to TCP, stream of bits are transferred, and now TCP divides this stream into segments of suitable size. And in this approach, there is no need of end of file or EOF representation. If we are dividing it into records, that is, if we are using record structure, then each record will have 1 byte of EOF character. Now coming to the second mode, that is block mode. Here the data is delivered from FTP to TCP as blocks, and each block is preceded by a 3-byte header. A 3-byte header is there, and the first byte represents a block descriptor, that is about description about the block. The second and third defines the size of the block in bytes. And now the third mode is compressed mode. As you know, why we need file compression? If the size of the file is large, then it will be difficult to transfer it from one place to another. So we will try to reduce the size of the file. So in compressed mode, file compression takes place. And the degree of compression depends on the type of the file we are dealing with. So this is an overall file transfer. So through the control process, through the control connection between the control processes, the commands are transferred, and through the data connection, data is transferred or file is transferred, and it can be storing a file, a retrieving a file, or can be retrieving a list. Next is anonymous FTP. So using FTP, we are transferring a file from one location to another location, or from one system to another system. So in order to perform this, we need, or FTP needs, an account. Account in the sense, we need a username and a password on the remote server. This is the normal case. But some sites have a set of files available for public access. So it is available for public access, and for such sites there is no need of such an account or a password. Instead, the user can use anonymous as the username and guest as the password. So any user, there is no need of an account. User can type the username as anonymous, then the password is set as guest. However, there is a limitation for this. That here we have told that some sites are having set of files available for public access, but there is some restrictions to the access of these files. Some sites allow anonymous users only a subset of commands, that is, all the commands are not permitted. For example, most sites allow the user to copy some files. That is, they can copy it but do not allow navigation through the directory. So they are not permitted to navigate. So this is the concept of anonymous FTP. So that is the end of this session. Thank you.